Today we are talking about gallstone problems. Let's describe some anatomy. When you swallow food, it comes down your esophagus to your stomach. The stomach empties into the first part of the small intestine called the duodenum, which curves around in a C shape and then runs down as the rest of the small intestine. The liver sits in the right upper abdomen. The liver makes bile, which is the green liquid that helps you digest your food. The bile flows out of the liver in a tube called the bile duct, which comes down and empties into the duodenum through a muscle called the sphincter of Oddi. The last part of the bile duct actually runs through the pancreas gland, which is tucked into the loop of the duodenum and lies behind the stomach. The pancreas also makes pancreatic juice, which helps you digest proteins in your food. The pancreatic fluid flows through another small duct called the pancreatic duct. The pancreatic duct drains into the same area as the bile going into the duodenum. The gallbladder is attached to the main bile drainage tube by a shorter, smaller tube called the cystic duct. The gallbladder is loosely stuck under the liver. The function of the gallbladder is to store bile. When you eat, hormone stimulation causes the gallbladder to contract and squeeze extra bile into the intestine to help you digest your meal. Gallstones form in the bile as it sits in the gallbladder. This is from a combination of chemical imbalance in the bile itself, and sometimes because the gallbladder is not squeezing properly. The gallstones usually start as a thick sludge, then grow like pearls into more round individual stones over time. The term for gallstones in the gallbladder is cholelithiasis. Not everybody with cholelithiasis will have problems or even know they have gallstones. Symptoms occur when the stones get stuck in the cystic duct and prevent the gallbladder from emptying properly when it squeezes. It is like a ball valve mechanism that blocks the emptying of the gallbladder where it connects to the cystic duct. So after you eat a meal, the gallbladder squeezes trying to eject the bile, but it can't because the gallstone is blocking it. This causes pain in the right upper abdomen that can radiate to the back or to the right shoulder, and this can also be associated with nausea. If this is happening and you are noticing problems related to gallstones, then we call this symptomatic cholelithiasis. Once you start having symptoms, the problems tend to persist and don't go away on their own, so we usually recommend removing the gallbladder. Because the stone can pop out of the cystic duct opening after a while, the symptoms may go away, then recur at some point in the future. The next level of the problem, though, is when the stone is stuck in the cystic duct opening and stays there. The bile then cannot get out of the gallbladder at all, and bacteria start to grow in the bile, and the gallbladder gets infected. This is called acute cholecystitis. Acute cholecystitis has the same symptoms of right upper abdominal pain and nausea, but also fevers and elevated white blood cell count on your lab blood work. The most common test to see cholelithiasis and acute cholecystitis is an ultrasound of the gallbladder. Acute cholecystitis, or an infected gallbladder, is differentiated on ultrasound by not only seeing the gallstones, but also a thickened gallbladder wall with fluid around it and tenderness when the ultrasound is pressed right on it. The other problem with gallstones are when they get out of the gallbladder and get into the bile drainage tube. If the gallstone is in the main bile drainage tube coming from the liver, this is called cholecystolithiasis. Cholecystolithiasis can be dangerous. One reason is that it can cause infections in the bile. A blocked bile drainage tube with infection in the bile is called ascending cholangitis. The infection in the bile can get into the blood and cause sepsis relatively easy with cholangitis. Infections and stones just in the gallbladder itself do not cause jaundice, but if the bile drainage from the liver is blocked by a stone in the main bile duct, then this can cause jaundice, which is what happens when bile backs up into the liver and then out into the blood and makes your skin and eyes look yellow. Cholecystolithiasis and cholangitis are treated by unblocking the bile duct, usually by using an endoscopy scope that comes through the mouth and comes into the bile duct through its opening into the intestine. The stones in the bile duct are pulled out into the intestine, and sometimes the muscle that controls the connection between the bile duct and the intestine, the sphincter of Oddi, is actually cut to allow the stones to come out. This endoscopy procedure is called an ERCP. The other problem with gallstones that get out of the gallbladder and into the bile duct is that this can irritate the pancreas. The pancreas juice likes to drain into the same area as the bile, and if the gallstones irritate the pancreas drainage, this causes inflammation of the pancreas, called pancreatitis. Any problems caused by gallstones getting out of the gallbladder and into the main bile duct are still an indication to remove the gallbladder itself, since this is the source of the stones. Briefly, let's talk about gallbladder removal surgery itself. The term for removing the gallbladder is called cholecystectomy. The vast majority of cholecystectomy surgeries are done through small holes using laparoscopic equipment, and so these are called laparoscopic cholecystectomy surgeries. The most common laparoscopic cholecystectomy approach is to make four small holes in the abdomen, and using laparoscopic long skinny instruments, we isolate the cystic duct that connects the gallbladder to the main bile duct. We place clips on this duct to prevent bile from leaking backwards out of it, and then divide it. There is a small artery coming into the gallbladder that is also divided. Then the loose attachments of the gallbladder to the liver are divided using an electrical cautery device. The entire gallbladder that contains the stones is removed. It does not make sense to open up the gallbladder and just take out some stones because they will reform in the future. Sometimes we inject dye into the cystic duct to light up the main bile duct drainage during the surgery, and this is called a cholangiogram. We do this to confirm anatomy or to check to be sure no stones are stuck in the main bile duct at the time of surgery. Once the gallbladder is removed, we pull it out of the belly in a bag. Most of the time, cholecystectomy surgery is done easily as a day surgery, but it can be harder if you have an active infection or acute cholecystitis, which commonly requires hospitalization to treat the infection and also to do the surgery. So to summarize, the goal of all gallbladder surgery is to be sure that there is good flow of bile out of the liver and into the intestine through the main bile drainage tube, and also to remove the source of any gallstones, which is the gallbladder itself. I hope this helps. Don't forget to subscribe and check out our other videos below. Thank you.